even know it. And the difference between the decisions you make today and the ones that you made last year, if they've gotten you to where you are right now, they were not good decisions. And so if we want to have more power in our lives, we have to first understand what power is, and second, how to unlock it through the actions and decisions that we make. And if you have a company or a business or a job where you need to influence other people, or you need to get people to say yes, or you need people to make decisions, or most importantly, make decisions for yourself that are going to change your life for the better, we have to understand what the topic means. If you don't know who I am, my name is Asha Mosi. I'm at acquisition.com. And 10 years ago, I was sleeping on a gym floor, and 10 years later, I'm now in my mom's basement. That is how much better my life is getting. This is actually a penthouse, and I like to work in a closet because I like having the quiet and not having distractions. But my life has gotten significantly better. And I recently spoke at CoachingCon, and they wanted me to talk about this specific topic because there was a series of events and decisions that made massive differences in my life, and I broke them down. And after I gave the speech and got off stage, I had hundreds of people who messaged me saying that that speech was one of the things that made them take huge strides in their life and honestly made them more powerful. And that is all I want for you, Mosi Nation, is to become more and more powerful so we can all make the world a better place. All right, so enjoy the presentation, and I'll see you guys on the other side.
It's just great to be here, so thank you guys so much. I promise that I will do my absolute best to give you a high return on your attention, because it's the most valuable thing you guys have. So I just want to thank you for investing in here with me today. So, that being said, the reason I went up with gold diggers, because we all know who's the real person who makes the money in the family. And so I picked right. That's, by the way, the best passive income strategy in existence is just to marry someone rich. They don't talk about that one, right? The second thing, though, that I want to talk about is power. And I think that, actually, before I get into that, who here wants to be powerful? Awesome. And that's not everybody who raised their hand, which is interesting. And I think I find it interesting because I ask that question sometimes, and in an audience, sometimes it's easier to remain anonymous. But one-on-one, when you stare at someone's eyes, you're like, do you want to be powerful? A lot of people shrink away from that. And I think it's because, at least me, when I was coming up, I had negative associations with the world. To me, power was like the emperor. The lightning, little fingers, anybody? And so to me, that was like power, but I saw it as a negative thing. And I feel like as I developed, I started learning that power is neutral. You can be incredibly powerful and bad, incredibly powerful and good. And so the idea is if we can harness power, then it amplifies who we are. And if we're shitty people, then we're very, very shitty people. If we're very good, we're very, very good. And so I hope that all of us aspire to have more power in our lives. And that is the underlying theme of the presentation I'm going to talk to you guys about today. So, decision making. Who's so excited about decision making? Well, I'll give you the sub-headline, which is selling with logic to make lots of money. And I think there are different selling styles. Because I've trained a lot of sales teams, we've built a lot of sales teams, sold a lot of different industries now. People sell differently. Who here would consider themselves like an emotional seller? Like you get like emotionally invested in the prospect, you get them to cry, anybody like that? You know what I'm saying? Cool. Who here is somebody who is more of a like, I'm not gonna let you leave. Types of, you know who you are, just raise your hand. I am that way too sometimes. Fair enough. And then the third is kind of logical selling, which is like, let's just talk through this, and if it makes sense, let's do it, and if it doesn't, no worries. Between those three types, I tend to actually be more of a logical seller in general. And I've gotten a lot of acclaim, rightfully or not, that was wild. sorry. I actually have a fear of birds. So this was about to be a very short presentation. And so a lot of my like success using logic in sales has given me a lot of acclaim. And this is the first presentation that I've put together. So this is just for you guys. It's a brand new presentation because I've been thinking about like reverse engineering. What are the things, what are the frameworks we think about to get to yes, right? And the yes that I want from somebody is not a yes, I'm gonna buy, but yes, I'm going to decide. And I think if you can delineate that for yourself too, it takes a little bit of the pressure off selling. Because my goal is to give this person power.
All right, that's 60, baby.
Understand what power is in order to give it, right? Who here knows the definition of power? Go for it. I love that. Thought to existence is what he said, which is actually a really favorite way. So the dictionary definition is the ability to influence or direct events or people. That's the dictionary definition. But I love how you said it, because as I see omnipotence, so God or a God figure, would be as they think it appears. So the distance between thoughts and reality, there is no distance, right? That would be an omnipotent being. If he thinks the world exists, right? And so as we take steps towards that as the ideal, we become more powerful. And if we can do that for our prospects, we can allow them to step into the person they want to be and make a decision to own their shit one way or another. Does that make sense? Cool. All right, let's rock. So this will either be the best presentation on sales you've ever heard, the worst presentation on sales you've ever heard, or somewhere in between. That is a promise, all right? And so I thought it would make sense to start with this. We have a high, this is Charlie Munger, who's probably like my number one hero in this season of my life. We have a high moral responsibility to be rational. And I think that getting someone to rationally decide is important, because emotional buyers oftentimes get excited, buy, and then who's had somebody who calls them 2 days later? It's like, I don't know why. Anybody? Raise your hand. Just so you know you're not alone. Okay. And what happens is, it's just like dating. I think Layla talked about it yesterday. If you have a rational foundation for a relationship or a decision, when the emotions fade, the logic will continue. And so it's good to answer both sides of the decision-making process. The short-term side is the emotion that gets you to decrease your action threshold and take a step, right? But the logic is what makes it stick and actually makes you a great customer, all right? And so for me, and I think that the further along you get in business and the higher up you get in business, the more you'll see people who tend to make more logical decisions, more logic-first decisions, and fewer emotional decisions, all right? So, what does rational logical have to do with selling? Well, you have logical buyers and you have emotional buyers in general, right? Most people sit on this continuum, one way or the other. And emotionally, people want to believe you. People want to buy. You must help their logical brains justify the decision that they already want to make. Think about it that way. They want to buy from you. You have to help them, right? So, who here identifies, actually, let's get through this. Emotional, logical, you're probably in between. Anybody in between these two? Anyone? All right, then you'll love this.
That's 100, baby!
I thought
106 minutes, 7 minutes.
About selling that have
all right, 6 minutes. Yeah, not bad.
Number one.
Not bad.
People want to believe you. They want to buy. You must help their logical brains justify the decision. Two, selling happens before you ask for the sale. Closing happens after. So you're selling for a lot longer period of time. But the moment you kind of like take your pants off and you're like, this is what it is, that's when you're closing, right?
All right, I'm going to finish off with five side-by-side push-ups. So it'll be 105. That's five. That seemed too simple, so we're doing another five, okay. That's 110. All right, I do it for you, I do it for me, I do it for we the people.